Hello, and welcome to another episode. In this episode, we're going to discuss the easy-to-find Leo Triplet Cluster of Galaxies and what's interesting about it. So, let's get on with it.
Okay then, to find the Leo Triplet, you need to start in the easily recognisable Leo Constellation. And it is easily recognisable because it looks like a sitting lion. So, once you've found the Leo Constellation, head down to the star on the hip of the imaginary lion. And from there, head down to a trail, almost directly down, of three bright stars. At the northernmost bright star, pan across until you see another bright star, not very far away. Now this is going to be a very important star because you're going to use this as your reference star. From here, you can find all of the galaxies located in the Leo Triplet, M65, M66, and NGC 3628. What I try and do is try and keep the reference star in my finder scope. So when I'm looking at one of the galaxies, I can try and pan back to the main reference star and then off to the next galaxy I'm interested in. Okay, so there's a lot to cover when discussing the Leo Triplet. I think it is best to go over each galaxy in turn, starting with the brightest and then proceeding through fainter galaxies. So the brightest galaxy is M66 and will look something like this through a 6-inch telescope. It is also faintly visible through 7x50 binoculars from a dark site. In 10-inch telescopes, you can start to see the spiral structure as shown in this stacked image of M66. M66 is a notable galaxy due to its large dust lanes and star-forming region, and it's been the location of several novae. The next brightest galaxy is M65, and all looks something like this through a telescope. Due to its high surface brightness, it is also visible through binoculars in a dark site. You'll need an 8-inch telescope to see any of the detail in this galaxy, as shown in this stacked image. While M65 is at slightly lower magnitude than NGC 3628, it has a higher surface brightness, which makes it easier to spot. The final galaxy in the triplet is NGC 3628, which should look something like this. As you can see, hints of the bar of what is also known as a Hamburger galaxy is visible even in a 6-inch telescope. In larger telescopes, it looks even more apparent, as shown in this stacked image. Strangely, NGC 3628 was the only part of the Leo triplet not found by Charles Messier, even though it is so close by to M65 and M66. Instead, it was discovered by William Herschel in 1784. The galaxies themselves are also close to each other, and are gravitationally interacting with each other. This has caused the Hamburger galaxy to be drawn out with young open star clusters and starburst regions. In the galaxy's tidal tail, after violent encounters with the galaxy's large neighbours. This interaction has also affected M66, causing asymmetrical spiral arms, although M65 seems least affected.
Well, I hope you enjoyed the episode. I was filming this on my new 4HD camera, so I hope you noticed the difference. If you enjoyed the episode and you'd like to see more astronomy videos, then please do remember to subscribe. And if you liked the episode, give us a like, it really helps out the channel. Also, if you have any comments or questions, then please leave them in the comment box below. Goodbye and clear skies.